Hello, welcome to my first makeup tutorial. I don't really know what I'm doing yet. This is all new and fun, so bear with me. So I got a request in the little question box thing that I posted for a no makeup makeup look. So this kind of look, obviously you don't want to look like you're wearing a lot of makeup, but you also don't want to look like a zombie, you know? I use this look a lot, like, you know when you wake up and your eyes are like swollen shut and your face is really puffy and you're just like not feeling yourself that day? I use this look on those kind of days. So yeah, let's get started. First of all, you always want to start with a primer. So I have the Smashbox Photo Finish primer. Yeah, so I just put a little bit on my fingers, and like before this I made sure that I washed my face and put lotion on so that there's no like flaky dry skin anywhere. You're gonna put a little bit on your fingers and you're basically just gonna put it on like it's lotion. Okay, next you're gonna take a beauty blender or a sponge of any type. You want to make sure that you wet it so it gets nice and fluffy. And then you're gonna take your foundation. So the foundation I use is Born This Way. And my color is light beige. Oh, I do two pumps and then I'm just gonna dab it onto my face, making sure I bring it down the neck. Today my eye circles aren't too bad, but there are days when my eye circles are really like purple and gross and need help. So we're gonna do some concealer. So I use Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, and the color that I use is Light Sand. The reason that I have this is because the color of foundation that I use basically depends on whether I'm wearing fake tanner or not, or if I'm tan or not. So right now, light beige matches my skin, but when I do have fake tanner on or if I'm tan, I use Honey, which is a much darker shade. And this concealer does a good job at balancing out your natural skin tone with the foundation tone. And as you can see, I kind of dotted it in all areas because you just want to make sure that not only the area under your eyes is lightened, but you want to have your forehead and your chin also concealed, just so that it kind of balances out your face. And because I'm not doing like a really heavy eyeshadow look today, you'll notice that I'm kind of blending it on my eyelids, and that's just because that'll give me kind of like a light base primer type of thing, because I don't really want it to look like I'm wearing eyeshadow. I'm just gonna use a little bit to kind of even out my eyes and give them a little bit of depth. So next I'm gonna do some eyeshadow. I'm using the Tarteist, I don't know how to say it, Pro. And I kind of use the same colors every time as kind of like a neutral, everything's falling, as like a neutral base kind of eye color if I'm not doing any like heavy shadow. I'm going to take my brush, it's kind of like a flat top lid brush, and I just kind of take a mix of these three colors, so the classic, the vintage, and the chic. So I'm gonna take those three, and it smells like chocolate, it smells so good. And then I'm just gonna kind of work that in on my eyelid. I have the Kat Von D translucent powder. It's great. So I just kind of like hit it onto the cap and then I unscrew the cap and there's just a little bit in there. So that's what I use because I don't wanna look like I caked my face on. So I dip my little beauty blender in it and set. Like, if you don't have a beauty blender, I highly recommend it. It literally works for everything. And usually I would let this bake a little bit longer if I was doing like a full-on glam look, but because we're just doing like a no makeup look, I'm just gonna let it sit for a little bit. So now I have this big fluffy brush from It Cosmetics, a powder brush. I'm just gonna kind of brush that all in to my face. And then the best part, contour. So this is the Too Faced Chocolate Matte Bronzer, and it's in Soleil. So I'm gonna take my little contour brush. So then I can make sure I'm getting my cheekbone area. Then I'm taking it up on my forehead, just so that I have some dimension, so that I don't blend into my hair. Especially like, if you're blonde and you like just get your hair done and your hair, like mine's growing out right now, but if your hair is like this color right here, it's really easy for your hair to like blend in with your face and for you to just look like a ghost. So, contouring the forehead is like really helpful with that. And then after that, I'm going to take this comb part of my brush and just kind of comb my eyebrows out. So for me, because my hair is so light, I actually, when I do this no makeup look, I don't really fill in my eyebrows, just because they do have a pretty good thickness to them, and don't have too many gaps. But if you do decide to fill in your eyebrows, my favorite brow product is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade in Soft Brown. Take an angled brush and just kind of line the areas of my eyebrows that have gaps in them. But I actually prefer just leaving my eyebrows natural so it doesn't really look like I'm wearing too much makeup or overlining them. Plus, when you do your brows really dark and you don't wear a lot of eye makeup, I think that it kind of looks a little funky. So we're just gonna leave the brows as they are. You could stop there. I definitely look much better than I did before, that's for sure. If you wanna open your eyes a little bit more, if you're someone who has light eyelashes, then you can take a little bit of mascara on the inner eyelashes, just to kind of open them up a little bit. So I use Better Than Sex, and I just kind of go in. And as you can see, I'm not really going out with the lashes. I'm just kind of putting it along my waterline area. And that is my no makeup look. We finished off by using some setting spray. I use Urban Decay D-Slick because my skin tends to get a little oily. I do have combination skin, but my biggest concern with makeup is making sure that it stays matte. You just spritz that, and then you are good to go.